Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be talking about the difference between octane numbers and cetane numbers, both of which are used as rating scales for fuels. So octane numbers are used as a rating scale for gasoline fuels and cetane numbers are used as a rating scale for diesel fuels. So first let's get into the basic definition. We'll go through octane and then we'll talk about what cetane numbers are. So the octane number is the measurement of a fuel's ability to resist knock. So what that means is, you know, a fuel with a high octane number can be compressed more without that fuel mixture igniting. So it's a measurement of how much can you compress that air-fuel mixture before it ignites. The higher the number, the more you can compress it. The lower the number, the more likely that fuel is to ignite all on its own from compression. Now, of course, in gasoline engines, we want to use a spark plug to start ignition. We don't want to use compression to do so, unlike diesel engines. And so a high octane rating is a good thing. And so our rating scale goes from 0 to 100, and you can go over 100. There are fuels with octane ratings greater than 100, but generally we're talking about this range with heptane being 0 and octane being 100. So both of these are hydrocarbons, heptane C7H16, 7 carbons, 16 hydrogens, and octane C8H18. And so octane has the rating of 100, heptane has the rating of 0. That means heptane is very likely to ignite from compression versus octane isn't very likely to ignite from compression. So why would you want that higher number? Well, that greater knock resistance, of course, knock is a bad thing. You want to time it with the spark plug, not through compression. But using a higher octane, you can use higher compression ratios. And higher compression ratios lead to more torque and greater efficiency. They also allow you to advance the timing, so you can fire the spark plug sooner and get peak torque to occur when that piston is closer to top dead center, create more torque, and have better efficiency. And they're also useful for forced induction applications, turbochargers and superchargers, when you have higher pressures within that cylinder and you want to make sure you don't run into any knock issues. So those lower knock rating fuels, those lower octane numbers, less resistance to knock, lower compression ratios used, and you know, not quite as much advanced timing used. And you'll see this more with naturally aspirated engines because of, you know, you don't run into those higher pressures. You don't necessarily have to worry about running into knock. So what is a fuel, for example, that has a 90 as its octane number? Well, what that tells you is it's kind of an equivalence of if it were made up of heptane and octane. So a 90 would be equivalent to a fuel that was 90% octane and 10% heptane. That doesn't mean that's what the fuel is made of, but it would behave like a fuel that was that blend of octane and heptane. And one of the things that always comes up whenever talking about octane ratings, everyone in Europe says, you know, like the US fuel quality is terrible, our octane ratings are super low. We use different scales. And so I have a separate video which goes all into that, which I'll include a link to. But generally speaking, the US uses AKI versus Europe uses RON, and RON tends to be a higher number, even if the fuels are the exact same. So I'll have a separate link which you can check out if you're curious about the different rating scales that different countries use. Okay, so now let's talk about the cetane number. And the cetane number is a measure of a diesel fuel's ignition delay. So what does that mean? Well, it's a measurement of the time from when fuel is first injected into the cylinder and from when that fuel first starts to combust. So it's a measurement of time, and you're looking at, so a high cetane number means that fuel ignites very quickly after it's injected in. A low cetane number means it takes a while for that fuel to start igniting after it's injected into the cylinder. And so your rating scale, once again, we're using two different hydrocarbons for a 0 and 100 rating scale. So cetane, just like octane is 100, cetane number, cetane is 100, C16H34. And our 0 is 1 methyl naphthalene, however that's pronounced, C11H10. And actually they've since switched to isocetane, which has the same chemical kind of composition, C16H34 as cetane, has a cetane rating of 15. The reason this is used rather than methyl naphthalene is that it's a bit cheaper, easier to work with. And so these may look exactly the same, C16H34, but the structure of them is very different. How the atoms are actually connected to one another is very different, which gives this the lower cetane number. So these numbers take a long time to ignite. You're going to have longer combustion. These numbers don't take very long to ignite. Combustion is shorter. And so the advantage of having that faster combustion is that you can create more torque and you can have engines performing at higher RPM because combustion doesn't take as long. You have less time for combustion to occur as you get into those higher RPM. And so it's important that that combustion speed, that that ignition delay is very short. It's also ideal for timing when peak torque occurs. So by having quicker combustion, you know, you can alter the timing of when you inject the fuel, but ultimately by having that shorter ignition delay, you can time that more perfectly with when you want that peak torque to occur within the cylinder so you have the maximum amount of work done. So it's ideal for timing because it burns very quickly, it ignites very quickly, and also you get less hydrocarbon emissions. There have been some studies that have shown that you can get a more complete burn with higher cetane numbers. But however, because this burns faster, it tends to burn a bit hotter, and as a result, you tend to get more particulate matter emissions. I've seen some studies showing this, whereas the lower combustion temperatures that result with these lower cetane numbers can result in lower particulate matter emissions. But overall, you're gonna have longer combustion and less torque produced. So, you know, the good on both of them, you wanna be kind of on the higher end. In gasolines, you tend to be 85 plus. Diesel numbers, they'll tend to be between about 40 and 60 for the cetane number. So hopefully this clears up the difference, what each of these two numbers mean when you're sitting at the pump and trying to fill up your car. Of course, I would just recommend going with whatever the manufacturer of your car recommends you use. If you guys have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave those below. Thanks for watching.